Hello students, this video we are going to see another one type of line problem. A line measuring 75 mm long has one of its ends 50 mm in front of VP. So here the one end is value is given 50 mm in front of VP, it is given. Next it is given as 15 mm above, 15 mm above HP. Then the top U length is given, the top U of the line measures 50 mm. The other end is 15 mm in front and above HP. Above HP means the value is not given but it is above HP. Draw and measure the front view. Draw and measure the front view. Determine the true inclination. So here we can draw a rough diagram. So whatever the given data, we have to plot it first as we know earlier. So we can draw the XY line, the reference line. And after this, the one end projection line, here it is given as 50 mm in front. So this is the starting point locus and 15 mm above HP. So here we can measure the both the things. Here for example, we can give the name as A dash A. Next it is given as the top view of the line measures 50 mm. So here the top view it is said. And once again, the other end is 15 mm in front, 15 mm in front, in 15 mm here it comes. So this will be the other end and it is above HP, the value is not given. So here we have plotted first value, second value and this is third value we have plotted. And the remaining values are the top view of the line measures 50 mm and the line measuring 75 mm. So these two values are pending. Now here this is the starting point. So from here you can measure, this is a top view, here you can measure in your compass, take 50 mm. So here this is the top view and also the true length is also given, it is 75 mm. From here you can measure 75 mm, this will be the true length. So below the XY line, that means in the top view side, we got both the true length as well as the view line, top view line, both the things we got it. Next, whenever we get the view line means we have to start with an arc then a straight line. So this is our procedure, we are knowing it. Whenever we got a true length, we have to start with a straight line and then an arc. So this is a thing we are already knowing it. So how we can do it? So this is another end, straight line, that means a true length. So here we can draw a straight line up to the next view starting point locus, then an arc. So the arc will be following like this. So it is going on like this. So we don't know where it will go and end. Right. Next thing. This is a view line. So here this is a starting end point. So keeping your compass here and this distance is radius. Draw an arc like this. Okay. And next you can draw the straight line like this way. So here from the view line, if you are going to draw like this means you will be get the true length. Here the true length is 75 mm. So from here you can measure 75 mm and it will mark it here and this will be the another end locus. So we got the another end locus and this point also we got it. So this is a front view line and this is a true length. So when we are going to check means these both the lines we should be parallel. The both the end projectors will be parallel. So now we got the lines. So this is a way of doing it. So here what they are asking, determine the true inclination. The true inclination is asking means this inclination we can get it and this also. This is theta and this is pi, we got it. We can take it. Then yes, draw and measure the front view length. So this length we have to measure and find. This is a front view length. So this is a way of doing it. So we can start the diagram now. First we can go for the XY line. So the XY line, Y, VP and HP, XY, and next the one end projection line. So we can mark it by perpendicular. So mark any one of the point here. Next, we can draw the one end projection line. We can draw the one end projection line like this. And next here we can measure 15 mm here. This area 15 mm and here it is 50 mm. And again 1 15 mm here. So these are things already we have said. So we can draw it easily. So once we have practiced by roughly in a rough diagram means it will be very easy for you to proceed. Next here, so I have drawn the lines. So this thing already I told, this is A and this is A dash, we got it. And next, by in your compass you can measure, first we can measure 50 mm, that is the true length, view line, top view line, that 50 mm, you can measure it keeping this as a center and you can mark it at here. Next, 75 mm, that is a true length. So now whatever the things we got it in the question, we are just plotting it in the diagram. So this is the thing we got it. Next, and also we can draw the lines. So the procedures are same, the value may be different, depends upon the value the diagram will comes like this. Okay, so we got the two lines. Next, already we know to draw the arc and the straight line, then keeping this as a center and this distance as a radius, just draw an arc like this. Okay, and next, draw a parallel line to this. And by here also you can draw the parallel lines. So here we need to extend it. I just extended it. So next, we know from the view line you will be getting the true length in the other view. So that taking the same 75 mm here, 75 mm, making the same mark, and I am just marking it here. So this will be the another end projection, another end locus. This is another end locus. So we got it. Next, I am just keeping this as a center and this distance as radius. This distance as radius. I am just making an arc like this. So this will make it here. So now I am just joining these two. So next, I can give the name. So here you know, these two lines will be parallel. By, you can check this, these two lines must be parallel. If you draw a line, perpendicular line means these two lines must be parallel. So your diagram is correct now. So this is B dash, this is B1 dash, and this is B1, and this is B. AB, and next this is B2 and this is B2 dash. So this is the thing. So here we can give the dimensions. The dimensions are, I will mark it from here, the end projection line away from the diagram, just take 10 mm away. You can mark the dimensions. This is 15 mm. And this is 50, and here I can mark it. This is 50 mm. And next, from here, I'll just draw it like this. So look at here, I am just drawing away from the diagram, that is 50 and this is 75. This is 75. So 1, 2, 3, 4 values, then this is the fifth one. So all the given data have been plotted. Next, in the question, they are asking to find measure the front view length. So here it is 6.7 or 6.8. So here you can write 68 mm. So you can write it like this. Next in the question, it is asked to determine the true inclination. So true inclination means here this angle you can measure and find it. So this is theta and this is another true inclination, that will be pi. So you can keep your protractor here and you can measure it. The value is, it is nearly 50 mm or 49 mm. So the theta will be 49 degree and here it is 28 degree. Pi it is 28 degree. So this is the thing, it is given. So here also you can write it here, locus of a dash and this is locus of A. So you can clearly understand here it is given as locus of A, this is locus of B. But in the before set problem, here the A will come and here the B will come. But the thing is the values are different. So that you can proceed the problem. So this is the one of the typical problem. Whenever the values are being different means you have to carefully read out the question and then you can proceed. Thank you.